Today, I'm going to talk about a bunch of awesome features from Redis 8 that no one seems to be talking about. Yes, the AGPL licensing option is very cool, but Redis 8 adds a bunch of new data structures to the open source version, like vector sets, JSON, time series, and probabilistic sets. But not only that, Redis 8 comes with over 30 performance improvements. I mean, Redis 7 was already really fast, especially for vector databases. Imagine how much faster Redis 8 is. Now in this video, we're going to go through some practical examples of just two of the data structures, purely because I didn't have enough time in this video to go through all four. But if you stick around till the end, you'll hear my honest opinion about them. Okay, so the time series data structure is great for analyzing and querying timestamped data. Think of databases like DuckDB, ClickHouse, and now Redis. Let me show you. Here is a monitoring dashboard with 6 fake sensors, 3 for temperature and 3 for humidity. It's currently sending data to Redis every 5 seconds, and if we scroll down here, it's aggregating this data based on a time range. So we have 1 hour, 6 days, 24 hours, and 7 days. But check this out. All this aggregation is happening from Redis queries. It's not happening on the client or the server. And look at how fast this is. That is wild. Let's go through the code. Over here, we're connecting to Redis via Docker. And down here, we have our 6 sensors with their fake values. By the way, make a mental note of the ID. We'll refer back to them later. And down here, we have our first Redis command, which is creating a time series with the ID of the sensor, and it's giving it a 7-day retention. Then we have another time series over here with a 30-day retention, but this time it has a label of the time series with a 1 minute afterwards. And what it's doing here is, if we scroll down, it's creating a time series rule and aggregating the values. So the values are being sent to Redis every 5 seconds, and here it's aggregating those values to get an average of a minute's worth of data, so 60 seconds. If we go down a bit more, we can see this tsadd command, which is adding the data points in a time-ordered sequence. This is happening for historical data points, and for new data points, that is happening down here. This all makes sense. But now take a look at this. So if we go down to the bit where the aggregation is taking place, when we click on the buttons, so 6 hours, 24 hours, and 7 days, this is the Redis query that's happening to grab the information on demand. So we have a TS range command, which is using the key. Again, that is the sensor ID, but the sensor ID differs based on the button that's clicked. So up here, this is using raw data, and these two are using the downsampled data. The from timestamp is up here. So again, this is from now to 6 hours, also known as 6 hours ago, 24 hours ago, and 7 hours ago. I hope that makes sense. So now if we look at this again, we're getting the range with a key and a timestamp. So for example, 6 hours ago, we're aggregating that data and putting it into buckets based on the value. So for 6 hours, buckets are in 5 minutes, 24 hours, they're 15 minutes, and for 7 days, they're an hour. And if we head back to the browser, we can see for 7 days, we have 5, and then 6, which is an hour, 24, we've got 3:30 and 3:45, which is 15 minutes. And for 6 days, we have 1:55 and 2 o'clock, which is 5 minutes. So it's getting the data exactly how we've coded it, but it's doing it really fast. I'm honestly impressed that a feature like this exists in Redis, but the next feature is even more impressive. Let's talk about JSON data structures. This is a user management system where I can register as a new user. In this case, it will be test 2. And once I've logged in, I can see my profile. I can add a bunch of extra data. But what's cool about this is that everything here is saved in JSON. So the last login, the last count, and all of these fields over here are all in a JSON object. If I log out and log in with a test person, so John Doe, we can see there's a bit more information in login history and login count. But I can also change the name, address, and theme preference, which doesn't actually do anything. But when I hit update profile, this is saved inside Redis. So if I close this tab and go to it again, we can see that all the information that I changed has been saved. But Redis is also managing the session. So if I open a new browser and go to the same page, we can see that I'm not logged in. I mean, who needs MongoDB, right? Let's take a look at the code. Again, we have an Express server that's connecting to Redis via Docker. We're starting a Redis session over here. And down here, we have our test users. So John Doe and Jane Smith with all the information that we saw in the profile. So login history, which is an empty array, and login count, which has a value of 0. Now, the username and passwords here are saved as a Redis hash using the hset method. The profile information here, so the user profile stuff, is saved as JSON using the JSON set command. Of course, there's also a JSON get command to get JSON data. But here's where things start to get really interesting. If we scroll down, we can see there's a JSON array append command, which is appending the login time data to the login history, which was an empty array. And there's also a num increment by command, which gets the login count and increments that by 1. But Redis also has a bunch of JSON specific commands that you can find in their documentation. So what do I think? And will I be using these in my projects? Well, to be honest, when I first saw that Redis was adding all of this functionality, I thought this was way too much and there's no way they could make it all work. But after actually using it, I'm pleasantly surprised. I mean, the fact that you can do all these things in an open source Redis is a massive win in my book. And I haven't even gone through vector sets or probabilistic data structures. So if you want me to go through those topics in a follow-up video, then please let me know in the comments